Hi, and welcome back to our e-telecast, God Has the Word for You, and I'm Pastor Aminata. And our theme is, Did You Get the Memo? And just in case you didn't get the memo, I'm going to read the memo. We're going to be going into the book of Revelations and look at the letter that God told John to write to the seven churches in Asia. And as I said before, we know that Revelations is the book of prophecy. So that we are actually living in the time of the fulfillment of that prophecy. Those who choose to be in denial, well, that's on you. But my question to you is, what church are you affiliated with? Now, I'm not talking about denominations. I'm not talking about Pentecostal versus Baptist versus Lutheran versus Methodist or the AME from the CME or any of those. I'm not talking about denominations in that sense. But we're going to look at what God is saying. And if you are like me, you want to be able to determine, where am I in this? Because when God says something, He knows what He's talking about. And don't let the enemy rob you or fool you or try to convince you, you know, that doesn't apply to you. You don't have to worry about this. But let's just get right into it. We're going to go to the book of Revelations, and we are going to start at chapter 2. And I shall read from the word of the Lord. To the angel of the church of Ephesus write, These things says he who holds the seven stars in his right hand, who walks in the midst of the seven golden lampstands. I know your works, your labor, your patience, and that you cannot bear those who are evil. And you have tested those who say they are apostles and are not, and have found them liars. And you have preserved and have patience. And you have persevered and have patience, and have labored for my name's sake, and have not become weary. So see, even though God is telling John to write this letter, He's going to let them know. Now, listen, I understand. See, I recognize and I acknowledge. This is what you did. This is how you were. And I accept that, and I approve of that. And I want to, you know, maybe I will go as far as to say, not consciously, but subconsciously, we treat God like we treat each other. And we have a tendency to think that we can maneuver or manipulate God or try to convince ourselves, which is trying to convince God that, you know, I'm really a good person, I'm not that bad, and all this other stuff. But God is letting you know something. He knows where your heart is, all right? But let me finish reading. Because even though the church of Ephesus did all these things, they persevered, they had patience, they began to see who was telling the truth and who wasn't, and they stood against it. What is God saying? He says in verse 4, Nevertheless, I have this against you, that you have left your first love. What is God saying to that? You know, just put yourself in that position. Think about it, when you are in love with the person you was in love with, and how they confessed their love for you, and how there was nothing that they wouldn't do for you. You know, and they showed how much they loved you by their actions, not only their words. And then one day, you found out that they were no longer in love with you. They no longer loved you. Think about that. And I know many of us have had that experience. How did you feel? What did you feel? But this is what God is saying. He says, you've left your first love. And He says, and I want you to know that even though you did all of that, I still got this against you. All right? Your priorities are not in the same place from whence you started out. But look what He says going on further, because I think this is important. He says, remember, therefore, from where you have fallen. See? They fell away from something. And He says, repent. He says, Repent and do the first works, for else I will come to you quickly and remove your lampstand from its place, unless you repent. He says, you have fallen. But God is telling them to repent. Because if you don't repent, I'm going to come and remove that lampstand from you. I'm going to remove my grace from you. I'm going to remove. Now remember, if God is telling him to take a memo, send that memo, and he says his word will not return to him void, don't you think he means business? But what does he mean when he says you have left? The Greek word for left is abandoned or forsaken or to leave destitute. Mm-mm-mm. And we can say that some of us, even though we're in church every single Sunday, we have abandoned God. See, we have displaced and misplaced our priorities. And this is all about motives now. It's about, you know, my motive. My motive is to worship and serve God and to be pleasing in His sight. Or my motive is to do my own thing. Or my motive is to please my pastor. My motive is to be the star in the choir. My motive is to make sure that I'm the best usher. My motive is all about me and not about God. And look what the Lord says in the book of Jeremiah 2:2. He says, go and shout in Jerusalem's streets. This is what the Lord says. I remember how eager you were to please me as a young bride long ago, and how you loved me and followed me even through the barren wilderness. See, when we first love somebody, there's nothing that we won't do. But what has happened to us? What has happened? What has gotten our attention that we could turn or neglect or fall away from God? How have we let the enemy slip in so subtly? And yet God has to send a memo down to us all the way from heaven. And are we paying attention? Did you get the memo? And if you got it, have you read it? And if you read it, are you going to stand there and say, well, this doesn't apply to me? Well, if it doesn't apply to you, God bless you. But if it does, God is saying, repent now. Because now is the time for us to get it right. See, when he calls your attention to something, if you're watching this e-telecast, then God is telling you something. Get it right. Get it right and get it right now. And we're going to continue because we got to go to church number 2. And we'll do that when I come back. I'm Pastor Aminata. Did you get the memo? Because God has a word for you.
Yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and that I need God in my life. So I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. Amen. So if you prayed that prayer, I want you to drop us a line and email us and let us know, because right now you are saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and find yourself a Bible-believing church and continue to grow in grace. God bless you.